Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And since we have Badger top of the tree, I believe it is about the time to make a video with this vehicle. I believe last time we had a video with a Badger, it was like 1 year ago. I believe a majority of you know my opinion about this tank. It's not my cup of tea, okay? And if the tank is starting with a word bad, well, I can't expect anything very, very good. Anyways, jokes aside, fellas, if you are curious equipment setup which I recommend to use and everything, feel free to check out the index page. You can see expectation values to get marks, expectation values to get A's, equipment setup, YouTube videos, easy to find field modifications, and we have this for pretty much every single tank in the game. So if you never ever noticed and you did not know about index existence, feel free to check it out. Today we will try to go for 4,500 with a Badger. I don't know how the things will go, okay? I have my own opinion about this tank, and I believe many of you are aware of that Badger has the best DPM in the world of tanks. But the thing is, DPM is not everything. Combination of the things is not that great. And in order for me to say something good about the Badger, we need to have a perfect situation of the things. Skill4ltu is the perfect situation of the things. Well, that's quite easy. We need to play hold down. Enemies need to make mistakes towards us. We need to farm them. This is pretty much the best combination of the things, and it is happening very, very rarely in the game, fellas. It truly does, so keep this in mind. Anyways, by any means, we are not going to give up. We will try to get as much use as we physically and possibly can, and we will try to get a lot of use of our DPM as well, right? So, first things first, what do we want to do? We want to take this position here, and hopefully from this position we will be able to get some early damage. Obviously, we are using the turbocharger on Badger, so the tank is going to become just tiny touch faster, and this is very, very important thing to say. And in this kind of situation, fellas, we are pretty much playing hold down, so we can chill as much as we want and we can enjoy ourselves. Now, luckily for us, we found the object 705A, who is in a way a tourist, you know. This is the situation which you want to see with a Badger. This is what you want to see, my friends. And whenever you are seeing the object, you are thinking, oh my bananas, this tank is pretty damn ideal, I would say. This tank is literally ideal, but boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, don't be tricked. This is very rare situation, and it's called turisticus tankus. Tank which is behaving and working like a tourist, fellas. This is how the things are looking like. It is very rare we are having those kind of situations. Trust me on this one. It is not happening too often, and I had a blast, fellas. I honestly had a blast. Now, as you can see, enemy Badger is sitting a hole down. Now, this is the best situation ever. Fellas, two Badgers. Both of the Badgers are hole down. Look at this. This is the funniest part of all this. Two Badgers, both of them are hole down. Aha! Right into the booba. Now, he's thinking how to penetrate us, and we are saying, aha! Right into the booba. And this is the playstyle with a Badger. I know it sounds very, very weird and everything, but this is in a way how you are playing with this tank, fellas. Quite nuts. It is weird, but it can work very, very well. And as you can see, in this kind of situation, we are booming and we are chilling in a way. Now, even speaking about the armor of the Badger, Badger armor is not bad whenever you are sitting perfectly hold down. It is not happening that often when you can have a game like this, when we are pretty much seeing the enemy tourists in a way, and everyone is crossing through the open field for us. It is not happening very often, but whenever it happens, it is always nice, and it is always much appreciated to pretty much punish enemies for one or another stupidity from their side, right? So in this kind of situation, we definitely need to get involved with skill. Why you fired so many gold rounds. Well, I was dealing against the badger, and as you can see, this gentleman was shooting us as much as he physically and possibly could. I was simply blessed pretty much more than he did, speaking about the penetrations, and that's about it. Speaking of the penetrations, beautiful shot into the side, and look how everything is looking like here. We have 4,000 damage dealt, we have 6,000 damage blocked because we had a badger who did not manage to penetrate us a single time. Actually, he penetrated a single time. I sincerely apologize, that's on me. But you get the point what I'm saying. This game was one of those lucky games in a way, which is happening once in a while. You cannot expect this kind of performance too often. Believe me, it is not the case. And this is what we have. First battle, 4,000 damage, 6,000 blocking damage. We played ideally, hold down, and we are chilling. I believe in the next game, what we are going to do, we will try to be aggressive with a badger, and you will see how armor is looking like on the flat ground. Whenever your weak spot is exposed, aka lower plate, right? And obviously, the worst thing for a badger, what could ever happen, you are getting permanently tracked, and then you are pew, pew, pew. Okay, so the first game, second by the damage, 4,000 damage, third by experience, very nice. And we even made some profits, even though we fired quite a bit of the gold rounds and gold ammunition to the enemy badger there. Okay, round number two, let's teleport right into the action. And we are back. One more thing which I think I forgot to mention, what kind of penetration this vehicle has. The standard penetration on the Badger is 272, which is very, very nice penetration, honestly. And gold penetration is 320, which is not super good in the current World of Tanks. For example, Russian tanks has 340 hit penetration, or 330 if we are speaking about the medium tanks. So we can't say it is a great penetration for a tank destroyer. It honestly isn't. Meanwhile, we have the EBR who is going through the open field. That's interesting. Can we hit Leo? I was trying to punish him. Hashtag never lucky. Okay, so what is our goal in this game? In this game, our goal is simply take this hold down position, at least for now. And we are going to fight with our friendly badger. Another one. The history is repeating itself a lot. The last battle we are fighting against the badger, this battle we are fighting against the badger. Wherever you are going to look at, you need to be afraid not to spit on the badger, fellas. And as you can see, enemy badger saying, F the shit, I'm out. Par 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 to the other side. I can't blame him, fellas. I honestly cannot blame this gentleman for this, because it makes sense. Now, once again, speaking about the flexibility, we are not very flexible with this tank. It is truly worth to highlight. Flexibility of this vehicle is not epic. So, in order to... what is the perfect recipe with this vehicle? The perfect recipe for this vehicle is to see enemies making silly goose mistakes, right? Whenever you are sitting perfectly hold down, you are having a great time and you are pretty much having conversation with enemies, right? This is what you want to see while you are playing with a tank like this. Nothing more, nothing less, fellas. That's what you want to see. For a chieftain, we can easily load the standard ammunition because we need to hit the cupola anyways. And we are trying to aim for his cupola. In fact, we are even going to the deeper settings here and we are trying to penetrate his cupola just like this. That's okay, relax, take it easy, we have a very, very good time, and they can shoot high explosives as much as they physically and possibly can, you know, I don't really mind whatsoever about this. And we are having a great time, because we are fighting against the opponents which doesn't really have the greatest penetration. For example, if I would fight against Jack Pizda in this kind of situation, I would not feel great. I can promise you that, fellas. It would be completely different situation and completely different story. Now, In this kind of situation, obviously we cannot do absolutely anything for a Mr. Badger, although we can change our position just tiny touch and we can farm this beautiful assisting damage. Very, very nice. I don't need 25 times zoom anymore, so we can get rid of this. And at this point, we are thinking how to defend our base. Because I believe it's quite clear we are having a lot of invaders. Skill, how much damage do you have? Zero. Skill, are you proud of your score? Absolutely yes. You see, it is, even though this vehicle has extremely nice DPM and you can eat mouse like there is no tomorrow, you can pretty much destroy mouse and mouse won't even understand what the flying ever happened. The thing is, to get yourself into position like this, it is quite complicated and it is truly not very easy thing to do. And this is a worthy highlight, fellas. It is truly worth to highlight this. It truly is. So, what we are going to do at this point, we will try to find this TB track. If we are going to be able to track this gentleman, this is going to be the best thing for us, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. But for that, we need to find his track. Ooh, Chieftain, hello there, how are you doing? Okay, we cannot do anything for a Chieftain. I repeat, we cannot do anything for a Chieftain, and it's really not worth to be aggressive. I need to come a bit closer to save this guy, so he is not going to get permanently tracked. And this guy doesn't give a flying F. Mate, I'm trying to help you here, just saying. I am trying to help you here so you can escape. Okay, never mind. Fellas, false alarm. I repeat, false alarm. I shouldn't help this gentleman. Ooh, that was a nice aim. And that was a nice pixel, I would say. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I'm not feeling whatsoever bad in this kind of situation. And I know, Skill, you don't really have an extremely good damage in this game. I am very, very well aware of that. But the thing is, I don't really know what I'm supposed to do to get more, you know? I think the best tool which we have is patience. And we simply need to be patient and wait until someone will make one or another mistake. And if you would pay attention at this Mr. Mouse can think about crossing like this. And oh boy, crossing he does. Ha! I hate this tank. I honestly, truly do. Anyways, okay. So what happened? We bounced at the side of the Chieftain with a gold rounds, which is just simply poor luck for us. We got penetrated all the time into the lower plate for obvious reasons, which is completely understandable, my friends. Can we kill him? Bam. Beautiful killing shot. And this is the result and this is the performance which we are getting here, fellas. Definitely not ideal situation for us. It is truly not ideal, but we are trying to fix it. We are trying to get as much use as we physically and possibly can, and we are just simply playing the game, right? Now, if we are going to be lucky and if we are going to be blessed, we are going to see enemy Jack Pizda somewhere in the, somewhere next to the red line, I would say. What would be the most unfortunate fate, I would say, if we are seeing Jack Pizda while he's shooting us from here, but there is a tiny possibility maybe this gentleman is AFK. Maybe. Okay, we are spotted. There is a chance we got spotted by this guy here, but honestly, I think... we got spotted by this sniper schnitzel from the back. At least that's what I want to believe. We will try to aim for his tracks, I would say, or something. Yep. As you can see, we are definitely spotted. And can we track him? Pretty please. Boom. Right into the track. Nice. With the damage. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And this gentleman should be dead. Or he should be tracked. Okay, look. This is a second battle. I believe this tank is not the most flexible tank in the field, okay? And I want to be very, very honest with you. This vehicle is quite boring tank to play with. The variety is not banana out of 10. You are, your perfect receipt and perfect gameplay. Sit hull down, do not expose lower plate, even raise your hull a bit to make the angle steeper, and you are going to be able to get a lot of use, right? In this game, for example, we are somewhere in the middle of the board with a 2,200 damage and with 900 base experience. Obviously, we have a bit of the tracking damage and everything, but you know, whenever you are expecting and whenever you are playing with a tank which has extremely good DPM, you know, the best DPM in the world of tanks, you are kind of expecting to get damage, not tracking damage, not assisting damage, not bouncing damage. You get the point what I'm saying. Anyways, let's go in. Actually, never mind. I was thinking to teleport into the next game, but we are already there. So what do we have? We have airfield game against the tier 10s. This is going to be quite hard one. This map is clearly called You Push, You Lose. I said that multiple times, and we need to find a position from where we can get a lot of use. I don't want to play here because I'm afraid of the sniper schnitzels here. So what we can do, we can actually try to play in the middle. I hope for the best, and I hope we are going to make this vehicle work. And also in the same time, fellas, I truly want to ask your opinion about this tank yourself. What do you think? Do you think Badger is a great tank and I am overreacting here a bit? By the way, I rated this vehicle as a playable on the index just because of that DPM and on those lucky games where you are actually going to be able to use the DPM. I am completely wrong and this tank is the most underrated tank in the world of tanks. I am very curious what you have to say, fellas, and what is your opinion. Can't wait to see that, so feel free to share your opinion in the comment section down below. Thank you. Okay, slowly but surely we are per arriving to position, and I want to start everything from the position right there. I want to see their sniper schnitzels, obviously, and we'll see, maybe we will be able to even farm them somehow, right? That's the end game goal for us. That's completely fine. I know, Super Conqueror. I am very, very well aware of that. I'm reloading quicker than he does, and I don't really think this gentleman is realizing this. Beautiful tracking shot. Now, if this guy do not have the repair skis in very, very big shithole, I can promise you that. Luckily for this gentleman, he had repairs, and we are hitting the E100 here very, very well. Meanwhile, oi, how is your repairs? F in the chat. F in the chat for this unlucky super con. Wow, that's a good repair speed. Ooh, fellas. That's a good repair speed on Super Conqueror. That's very impressive, man. Extremely impressive. So he is fixing his tracks quicker than 6 seconds. Wow, that's actually impressive. I did not saw that one coming, and I did not expected this, but this gentleman got me well. Wow, I truly thought we are permanently tracking this guy, but as you can see, I am wrong, and there is nothing bad to be wrong. We lost quite a bit of our HP for a gentleman who penetrated us sideways, so aka the Centurion action shit. And obviously we took one for the team from the Arta. Actually, in fact, two for the team from Arta and one from Super Conqueror. That's completely fine, we still have half of HP left. There is nothing to be worried about, and in the same time I am just simply trying to blind fire the E100 for obvious reasons. Wow, I'm truly surprised how good of the repair speed the Super Conqueror had. Very, very impressive. Very impressive, fellas. Indeed. Okay, once again, you push, you lose. We cannot make too much pressure, but what we can do, we can try to work on the angle of penetrating or punishing the Centurion action shit and TVP. So this is all we need to do, and we are sitting on quite a nice relaxation level in a way. Ooh, brother from other mother, Badger is going into the attack because he was bored already of doing nothing in this game. Okay, TVP, can we? Unfortunately, we cannot. Okay, maybe. TVP, hi. Beautiful shot to the TVP, and unfortunately we are taking one for the team from the C100. Nice shot by E100, nothing to say, nothing to add. Unfortunately we are missing the other shot to E100 ourselves, which sucks. Can we punish this guy? I heard Arta, high explosive penetration, 400 in the face, dead. I don't know, what do you want me to say about this thing? I truly don't know, fellas. Let's go for one more game, okay? I want to play one more battle. Maybe we are going to have a game where we will get 6,000 or 7,000, because this tank is capable of that, but I just simply think this tank is quite weak overall in the game, and it's just bad. Okay, let's go, one more game. And we are back with a score, 2,800 damage, 400 assisting damage. Ooh, fifth by the damage. By the way, even Arta did more than we did, unfortunately. And the fifth by experience, actually sixth by experience. I don't really know what I supposed to say, fellas. Badger is definitely not my vehicle, and I cannot appreciate this vehicle. I just simply can't. Anyways, let's go to the next game, shall we? Okay, fellas, we are back. Now we have two options how to do the things. We can find a hold down in pretty much every single area, and I want to believe we are going to fight against the 279E. So what we are doing, we are actually going into the city. We will try to find a solid hold down for ourselves, and fingers crossed we will be able to get a lot of use, right? That's the whole plan, the whole dream, and the whole hope. What position I am thinking about? I am thinking about taking this hole down at least at first, and after that we'll see, can we get more involved into the game. What I am afraid the most, obviously of the Artas. Because once again, this vehicle is not Arta immune. This tank, as you seen in the previous game, we pretty much got destroyed by the clickers, right? And it wasn't very enjoyable, and it wasn't very good. Meanwhile, fellas, we are still feeling all right here. Well, kind of all right. And I want to see enemies crossing. Unfortunately, we cannot find them so easy as I would love to. And 279E is regretting his life choices. Meanwhile, I think 60 TP maybe could penetrate this guy. I am not entirely sure, but whoever did, he did a bloody great job of penetrating our object. Meanwhile, unfortunate for object for 30, but he took a humongous for the team, and he is not enjoying himself. And we have the E4 who is sniping from the back with a full APCR, which is completely understandable. This is what we can expect. So what we are doing, we are going backwards. I do not want to fight against the E4 with APCRs, okay? E4 with APCRs is super duper hyper turbo powerful tank, and we cannot do absolutely anything for him. So instead of crying in the corner and complaining of us getting slaughtered, I would rather escape, and I would rather have obviously better position for myself where we can play well, hold down or something. Meanwhile, we have a Bobject friend next to us. Greetings to you, Mr. Bobject. And you know what we are going to do? We are going to take a position here. Hopefully from this position we will be able to craft another nice angle, and hopefully we will get a lot of use. So far for a start, it is okay. We did couple of shots there, and in the same time we still have full hit points. So definitely not the performance for which we would complain and cry about. Can we be aggressive for the enemies? No, fellas, we cannot. There is no chance we will be able to eliminate the enemy forces while being aggressive. So I would rather be smart than say no, you know. and I believe that makes sense. Meanwhile, for those who did not know, this is a very good angle, and from here you can find a shot to the people who are trying to play here. By saying you can find the shots, you can find the angle, obviously, but you need to be kind of tall tank in order to do so. And as you can see, fellas, our vehicle is not so tall. In fact, it is in a way like a cabrio, so yeah, this is not so easy. Anyways, relax, take it easy. We will try to hit this gentleman just like this. Beautiful shot, extremely beautiful shot, fellas. And this is exactly what I want to see, and this is how I want to play my game. Another beautiful shot into the MX5120, and the MX5120 is probably questioning his life choices, and he is having question mark in the chat currently. How we managed to punish him like this, right? Okay, so what do we have? We have the IS-7 close to us, that's okay, and we have 279E close to us. At this point, we are going to be aggressive. At this point, I am not too afraid and I am not too worried. Why so? Well, the answer is relatively simple, fellas. We can get closer. Or can we? Or can we? Okay, we are playing cooldown, enemies are going with a full gold on, so we can load the gold as well, and we can burst them like there is no tomorrow. In the current world of tanks, my friends, it is not so simple to do the things, right? Especially with the tanks with which you supposed to have armor. I am using this sign as well, supposed to have armor, because it is not so simple as I would love to say. I see the 60 DP with one hit points, next to us, but I cannot change absolutely anything. Although I think we can actually turn for him, and now he is going to be a bit afraid, I would say. He should be a bit afraid. Good, very, very nice. Can we get a bit more involved here? It would be much appreciated. Going with high explosives like there is no tomorrow, everything is completely fine. And moment of truth, can we beat the living crap out of this gentleman? As you can see, the 60 DP, he is not making silly goose mistakes. He is not thinking about side scrapping or something, and this is quite sad thing for us. But this is as much as we are going to get. I am shooting once and I am trying to bait this gentleman to peek against us, but as you can see, it is so much more complicated than this, unfortunately. Yeah, shame. Another game with a badger and I did not make this tank work, fellas. I tried to do my best, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. I was trying to play as well as I physically and possibly could, but unfortunately this is not so simple. And that's what I am talking about whenever I am saying about the Mr. Badger, right? It is not the easiest tank to play with. In fact, in my humble opinion, this is very... What the flying? Yep, in my humble opinion, it is very, very complicated tank to play with. And it in the same time, unfortunately, but for my taste, it is boring tank. So once again, it's fine to sit hold down until you are meeting people with a high penetration, for example, 279E, can shred you like hot knife through the butter, Jack Pizda and any other tank destroyers, to be fair with you, unless they are unlucky like IS-4 was, or E-4 was, I apologize. Speed, very, very, very bad of this vehicle, and overall combination of the things is just simply pathetic. I'm sorry, fellas, this is an honest review, and I think this tank is just weak. So, after 4 games with this vehicle, we was packing 3000 damage and 800 assisting damage. Is it good? To be fair with you, it is quite pathetic score considering what kind of DPM this vehicle has, but this is good showcase of the tank, and this is the main reason why you should not trust the paper in World of Tanks. No, but skill on the paper, you have 4.2000 DPM. Yeah, but what's from that if you cannot use it? This is the thing. So sometimes it is better to have tank like, for example, Trash Barn. at least when you will smack someone, you will smack someone, and that person will remember this for rest of his life. Badger, yeah, I think it is weak tank, and the main reason why am I rated this vehicle to the playable category is just because of those rare games when everything is going well. So yeah, that was honest daily dose of skill, fellas. I hope you had a great time. I tried to make this tank work, I failed, sorry. Have a good one, fellas, enjoy yourself, and thank you very much for watching. I hope you had a great time, and hopefully you won't grind this line yourself. Take care, skill is out, peace.